Hey, what's up, everybody, and welcome back to That Triathlon Show, the podcast presented by scientifictriathlon.com. I'm your host, Michael, and this is Beginner Tip 27, where we will discuss nutrition fundamentals for triathletes and endurance athletes in general. But first, big thanks to our sponsors, Precision Hydration, that make electrolyte and hydration products. They help you stay on top of your hydration, which is just as critical as nutrition when it comes to your training and racing. And how much you need? Well, that is individual, and that is why Precision Hydration have a free online sweat test on precisionhydration.com that you can take. It takes just a few minutes, and you will find out how much electrolytes you need to consume in training and racing. Something a lot of people have been asking about with related to this is how to get fluids in on the run. And this is especially relevant in the recent heat wave that has been going through the Europe and UK in particular. And Andy from Precision Hydration wrote a useful blog with practical advice on that topic, and also included how to master running through aid stations and grabbing drinks and consuming that on the go. So I'll link to that blog post in the episode description. Remember that you can get your first box for free when you use the promo code THATTRIATHLONSHOW, all one word, all caps. And thank you to Roka. They make the highest quality triathlon wetsuits, apparel, equipment, and eyewear on the planet. You can check them out on roka.com. If you are looking for a wetsuit, you can be comfortable knowing that every wetsuit in the Roka lineup has their unique arms up technology, which makes such a big difference in flexibility that even Roka's entry-level wetsuit, the Maverick Comp 2, is more flexible in the shoulders than any top-end suit from anybody else. So it's amazing what that flexibility can do for a beginner triathlete's confidence when they don't feel restricted by their suit. So definitely check out that Maverick Comp 2 if you need a wetsuit. And of course, we have a promo code for you. It is That Triathlon Show, all one word, all caps, and that will give you 20% off your entire order on roka.com. So, nutrition fundamentals. Nutrition is a very hotly debated topic, as you know, in media, both mainstream and triathlon. So that's why I thought that it would be helpful to make an episode on this topic as a beginner tip, where it's all boiled down just to the essentials. So let me start by sharing one top resource on the topic that I highly recommend that you follow and check out, and you can use that as your filter for good and bad advice and information of nutrition. And that is Matt Fitzgerald, nutritionist, award-winning endurance sports author, and endurance athlete and coach himself. And in particular, he has written many books on nutrition. In particular, I recommend The Endurance Diet, which is not really a diet. It's just a way of eating, agnostic healthy eating. But also check out Diet Cults. That will help you as a filter in this media frenzy. And of course, follow him on Twitter, where you can see some tidbits and nuggets every now and then on nutrition. The second thing I want to say before diving into the real tips is that there is no one-size-fits-all approach when it comes to nutrition. So what is ideal for one person may be quite different from that of another. So whenever I do episodes like this, it is an attempt at giving advice that works really well for most endurance athletes. But just know that there are outliers for whom another strategy may work better. And if you find that that's you, then do what works best for you. If you notice better health, better performance by changing something particular in your diet, then that's a good thing. Stick to it. And third, this field, as many fields of research, is always evolving. So if you listen as this is released in July 2018, this episode would pass any fact check. But who knows what we have learned 3 years from now in 2021. Things may change, so stay subscribed to the podcast and keep listening, and I'll be sure to tell you what we learn as we learn more in this field. All right, so let me start with the actual tips of nutrition fundamentals. I actually thought for a long time about how to convey this information and boil it down to the essentials. And I'll again credit Matt Fitzgerald and his book, The Endurance Diet, because most of these concepts I basically got directly from that book. I totally agree with that. It is all based on both science and what elite endurance athletes in the real world are eating. And of course, they are among the healthiest and best performing people in the world. So that tells you something. Matt has a whole chapter on why you should eat like an elite athlete, even if you're not elite, even if you're a beginner. And it makes a lot of sense. We don't have time to go into that right now. But you shouldn't look at them as a different species. If you want to do your nutrition right, then you should look at what the best athletes in the world are doing and follow that. And what they're doing is also in line with what science tells us is optimal. So the first real tip here is eat everything. Do not eliminate food groups. Do not eliminate or focus on minimizing certain macronutrients like carbs, fats, or protein. Do not even eliminate unhealthy indulgences completely. We'll get to that in a minute. And because if you don't follow this, if you don't eat everything, then first of all, you could actually be doing yourself physically a disservice and physiologically a disservice, I should say, by not getting enough of certain nutrients, whether it's micro or macro, that your endurance sport require. But also psychological, and that is common if you eliminate unhealthy indulgences. Like if you forbid every sweet, cakes, ice cream, etc., then actually that's a first step towards eating disorders. I'm not saying that everybody who does that has an eating disorder, but most elite endurance athletes, they do not have any of the sort of prohibited food for them. They eat everything, but they just don't eat mostly ice cream or mostly cakes. They use it as a treat every now and then. And most of what they're eating is really healthy. So they can do that. And so can you. And so should you. So eat everything is the first tip. Tip number two is focus on quality. And this is where I think that most media, and therefore also the general public, get the message about nutrition all wrong. The focus in media is often not on quality, as much as it is about specific macronutrients, or specific food groups, or specific micronutrients, or specific superfoods. Keep it simple. In the endurance diet, there is a system called the diet quality score, and that allows you to actually score the food that you eat very easily yourself, and therefore track the quality of how you eat without worrying about tracking calories and macronutrients. So I won't go into that in detail, but the point is with that system to prioritize eating the following very broad groups of food, with the number one that I'll list in a second being the group of foods that you should consume the most, and so on down in order of priority. And these groups of food are 1. Vegetables, 2. Fruits, 3. Nuts, seeds, and healthy oils, 4. Whole grains, 5. Dairy, and 6. Unprocessed meat and seafood. And although you don't need to and shouldn't completely eliminate the following unhealthy groups that I'll list in a second again, these are the groups that you want to consume a little and much less frequency than the healthy food groups that I listed above. And number 1 on this list is the least bad of the 4, and number 4 is the worst. So 1. Refined grains, 2. Sweets, 3. Processed meat, and 4. Fried foods. So that is tip number 2, focus on quality. And you can use the diet quality score system from the Endurance Diet book. You can even Google it. I'm sure that you can find how it works. And there is an app for it as well that I believe is free. I'm not quite sure. So Google around and you can see how it works in detail. Okay, so tip number 3 is eat enough and eat frequently enough. I think that too many people focus too much on the amount that they eat. And often this is the case because the quality of their nutrition isn't high enough. So do not skip meals. Even if you don't train a whole lot, you're likely a beginner since you're listening to this beginner tip. But even if you don't, you should be having breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and maybe some snacks. Something, it can be as simple as an apple or something. It all depends on your energy expenditure, but do not skip those basic meals and do not skip breakfast. Most people, they really overestimate the correlation between food volume and calories, But if you actually make a really healthy big salad full of high quality ingredients, vegetables and fruits and stuff, you'd be very surprised by how few calories it actually contains per unit of volume. And if you compare to how big it looks on your plate, it can actually contain quite few calories, much less than you would expect, compared to even just a small piece of ready-to-eat microwave heated food that you would buy in the supermarket that can contain a whole lot, even though it looks very, very small. So focus on eating enough and eating frequently enough. And if you eat mostly high-quality food using the diet quality score system or your own system, just agnostic healthy eating and thinking really, you will find it much easier to eat enough, but not too much, as you will get so much stronger satiety signals compared to some of the pre-mailed meals that I just mentioned, because they're all juiced up with salt, sugar, and fat to artificially induce an addiction to that processed food. And this is something I've actually been listening to an audiobook lately called Salt, Sugar, and Fat by Michael Moss. It's all about the food industry and how they make processed food, snacks, that sort of thing, and soda, etc., really, really addictive and really unhealthy by just trying to. It's a whole science. It's an really advanced science and really interesting to read. And I highly recommend that. I'll link to that book in the episode description as well to give you an idea. But that's the reason why something that may look very small can have a lot of calories, and something that you make from scratch, from healthy ingredients that are unprocessed, can have much fewer calories than you may think. If you do want to lose weight, yes, you will need a caloric deficit, but don't go too extreme, because then you will only start losing muscle mass and your basal metabolic rate will slow down. So that also means that your weight loss will slow down. Episode 113 of that Triathlon show is all about body composition and getting to race weight. And that will help you basically know more about how big a caloric deficit you can have and what other steps you should take to make sure that you lose weight in the right way, lose body fat and not lean muscle mass. So eat enough and frequently enough was number three. And number four is do not focus on macronutrients. This is advice that I think is especially relevant for beginners. I wouldn't necessarily say that this is true for athletes that do larger volumes of training, like 7+ hours per week, because at that point, it does start to matter a bit more, and in mostly in that they need to make sure that they get both adequate carbs and adequate protein. But for beginners with small training volume, it really isn't that important. I don't think that you should focus on that, because that can take away your attention from just focusing on the quality, which is much more important. So I have some related episodes on that, episode 94 and 95, which they are called Triathlon Nutrition, Calories, Carbs, Fat, and Proteins, Part 1 and 2. I'll link to them as well in the episode description, so you can learn more about that. But anyway, do not focus on macronutrients. It really is like a corollary to the first tip that I gave you, eat everything. But I did want to specifically point this one out in its own right, since a lot of the diets out there and the nutrition advice really focus on macronutrients, whether it's LCHF, HCLF, Atkins, or whatever the next diet craze will be. And I think that especially for beginners, this is really a dangerous trap to fall into. I would not recommend that you go down that route, because it is about quality. There are quality fats and there are bad quality fats. There are quality carbs and there are bad quality carbs. There are quality protein and there are bad quality proteins. So it's really, you should choose the quality variant of all your macronutrients mostly. Again, allow yourself some indulgences every now and then, and try to minimize the amount of crap variants of all of those macronutrients. But don't focus on actually having a certain amount of macronutrient or trying to minimize any certain kind of macronutrients. As a general piece of advice, if you are on a named or labeled diet, I would change that as soon as possible. Get off that. You do not need that. Finally, some bonus advice, supplements. If you don't have any particular medical conditions, then the advice that I've already gave you goes 95% of the way to ensure health and performance. Supplements can be useful, but it's a small cherry on top. So don't focus on them until you first got these fundamentals in place. That said, some supplements can be really good, like vitamin D, especially in winter, in climates where you don't see a lot of sunlight. It can be really, really important. So I'm not at all discrediting supplements. I use them myself. But don't make the mistake of focusing on supplements over getting these fundamentals right and nailing the basics. And also sports nutrition products. It is a good idea to use some sports nutrition products like sports drink and gels if you have workouts that are 75 minutes or longer or so, definitely as they become longer than 90 minutes. And also in races, if you're going to race for around that time or longer. So I also have a related episode for that, and that is called Nutrition Before, During and After Workouts. It is episode 100 on That Triathlon Show. So check that out. All of these resources, different related episodes, are linked to in the show notes. One more episode that I have linked to is Beginner Tip 12, which is called Training When Overweight and How to Lose Weight. I've also linked to The Endurance Diet and Salt, Sugar, and Fat by Michael Moss, as I mentioned. And that's about it for this one. But I just want to read a review that got in on iTunes recently from Malaysia. It's titled Age Grouper, 5 stars, and it's from Salty Sam, 1907. He writes, absolutely brilliant. I stumbled on this podcast as I was looking for advice on triathlons. I'll listen to 20 plus episodes and I'm absolutely hooked. Thanks, Michael. This is such an awesome resource for beginner age groupers like me. Really appreciate all the hard work that you put into this. So thank you so much, Salty Sam, and best of luck with your training and races. And for all the other listeners, if you haven't already, please take a minute to leave a rating and review like that on iTunes. Or if you use another podcast app where you can leave ratings and reviews, do that. And note that you can leave a review on iTunes, even if you're not a Mac person, you're not an iPhone person. You can just download iTunes for Windows. It's free and it takes a few seconds and you log in and then you rate and review. And just like that, you're done and you've done me a massive favor, which I really appreciate if you find value in these podcasts. So the next beginner tip will be hydration fundamentals, a logical follow-up to nutrition fundamentals. And that's about it, but let's thank our sponsors, Roka, that you can find on roka.com. And remember that you can get 20% on your entire order of whether it's wetsuits, apparel, equipment, sunglasses, anything, using the promo code THATTRIATHLONSHOW, all one word, all caps, on roka.com. That's roka.com. And Precision Hydration, that you can find on precisionhydration.com. Both of these URLs are linked to in the episode description, by the way. And Precision Hydration makes sure that hydration is not a one-size-fits-all, or I should say they help you with your hydration, since hydration is not a one-size-fits-all. And that all starts with their free online sweat test that you should take and learn how you should hydrate for your individual needs. And if you decide to buy any other products, you can get your first box for free using the discount code THATTRIATHLONSHOW, all one word, all caps. Thank you, as always, for listening. Keep training smart and keep loving triathlon.